All right.
How you doing? Thanks for tuning in. I'm really glad you're here. The only day I'm working this week. Jimmy, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed this morning. 7:05, I'm here.
Look at all the motorcycles. We're not a motorcycle shop. The heck?
We'll fix just about anything. We don't care. If it runs and has tires on it, we'll fix it. Tractors, trucks, classics, doesn't matter. We'll fix them all. Before I finish opening up the shop, what I'll do instead is I'll put in a few clips so you know what to expect in today's video. Super clean 2001 Tacoma. Let's do our best to learn a thing or two and have some fun today. We got to make it count. We got one day. Maybe what I'll do is if I have a few interesting repairs, I'll make three separate repair videos instead of a day in the shop this week, but we'll see. It all depends on how things go. One thing I'm going to try to do is empty some of this garbage and stuff like that, because stuff's starting to stack up, you know? Stay tuned. They keep the batteries dead in this Toyota. I mean, stone dead. There's nothing lighting up. The key's kind of weird. Hard to get it off, so you can get the key out. You got to play with the shifter, apparently. But we're going to try to jumpstart it. I'm going to use the old J400. See if this little guy can keep impressing me. Give it another go. It is a light duty jump box, but so far it's worked surprisingly well for its size. Diminutive is how I would describe it, I guess. Let it count down, get itself oriented. How many volts are in it? 6 volts. Let's see if it'll start this little truck up. Nope. Okay. Let's try a little harder. Make sure we got a good connection. And reset it. And we'll try it again. Both lights are green now. There was one that was a little orange. Could have been because the battery's so low. Could have been my connection wasn't that good. Nope. That's not good. I thought it was going to start it. All it has done is discharge my jump box. That's not very impressive. Let's get another jump box. All right, now we're gonna try the JS3000 from Top Don. Boost. That jump box is only halfway charged, and it did it. That says a lot. Maybe that little jump box is not as impressive as I had hoped. I want to get this up to the shop, put the charger on it, because that battery is so dead the little jump box wouldn't do it. All right, we got the charger going. We'll get this battery charged back up, test it, make sure it's good. We're gonna do the idle control valve we talked about. You got to take the throttle body off. It's underneath, so testing it's very difficult. So our plan is to remove the throttle body, turn everything over, disconnect that valve, and then turn the key on and off to see if the valve moves at all, which I suspect it's not gonna. If it has 7 to 8 volts on the control wires and voltage changes when you, well, you can't really start the engine with the throttle body off. Bad things might happen. But the theory is you crank it or start it and then you can see if the valve moves. I guess you'd have to put the throttle body back on and all kinds of crazy stuff, so. We're gonna end up putting that throttle valve on. It's gonna be stuck. All right, I got this popped out, got some clamps loose. I'm gonna get this box out of my way in the tubing so I can get the throttle body off. Shouldn't be too hard to do. I think I can leave the coolant hoses on. I'll have to take this PVC or breather hose off. Shouldn't be too bad. These are all plugged. So there's an electrical connector for the TPS sensor, which is on the other end of the throttle shaft. We got an idle stepper. I think that's actually used to let the idle reduce slower when you decelerate. I can leave the cables and stuff, I think. But I just want to get everything out of the way so I can slide it off and turn it over. Because I want to at least try to see if this thing tries to move. I don't suspect it will. It's kind of like the crank sensor on the Nissan. You already know what the problem is. And in the flat rate world, you start chucking parts. But I like to at least check a few things and make sure I'm on the right track. That's what we're going to do with this one, too. We already got the parts. That's what it looks like. See the little, there's a little rotary valve in there. And it'll be like a plunger. It's got a three-wire sensor on it, or control, actually. It's got two coolant hoses to it, so I guess we will have to open the coolant. All those coolant hoses do is keep it from freezing in really cold climates. We don't have to worry about that here. Let's get this stuff off of here.
There's two 12s underneath this baffle to get it off. And I had to take these standoffs loose too, so I can fit it out of there.
A couple studs on the bottom. I'm going to disconnect some more things from this just because there's a lot going on right here in this little area with the hoses and things I have to disconnect. So the things that are easy to take off, I'll just get out of my way, and I only have to contend with a few things that are left connected. Some 12 millimeters hold this on. There's one under there, a little tricky to get to. The other three you can see pretty easy. And I gotta take the throttle cable bracket off of there too. Those are a couple of tens. We'll do that quick first. Don't try falling out of there. There's a lot going on, and it'll be like never, never land. Whew. A little tighter than I thought it would be. Don't worry, I got something for that. Quarter drive tools should be fine for this, but. I gotta go around and pop them all loose. I can't see, help. There it is. They've never been off. That's OEM tight. There's only one bolt left in there, and right at the top. Needs a little encouragement to come off. Now, we'll get these coolant hoses off of here. Gonna lose a little coolant. I don't mind that. I just don't want it to go in the intake. That's my only real concern. I might need to get my 90 degree deals. I'm not sure if I can get to that with the long ones. You guys that have been around a while, if you remember, but I found these on top of a gas tank years ago. I put a fuel pump in a Chevy Suburban, had these on the tank. Thanks to whoever left them there. Appreciate it. The tool gods giveth, the tool gods taketh away. So, you can see, all this is just to test it. I mean, I guess you, maybe you can get back there and see what you're doing. I don't think so. Now, I'm not gonna let this go in the intake, but I do want to raise it up so it won't drip off too much of the coolant. Should be good. Woohoo! You're not gonna do that without one of these JS screwdrivers or whatever this thing's called. These Japanese standard screwdrivers. Yeah. Can't even get that one. It's crazy how tight they are. I'm gonna have to get a hammer. Luckily with these vessels I can hammer on the back like an impact driver. Bust it loose. Back here. Tight screw. Uh-oh. Don't you do it. Don't you do it. Oh. Gotta get a better magnet. Thank you. Rotary dealio. Kind of strange. Looks like someone's been here sanding stuff and working on stuff. Someone's been messing with these screws, trying to patch it up, I guess. I know one thing. We're gonna put the new one on. This thing's trash. That's not too hard to tell. This is not in good shape. I might get burned, but I'm just gonna put the new one on while we're in here. Someone's been playing with it already and trying to clean it out, it looks like. So we'll just put the new one on. I'm pretty confident with that. Maybe I shouldn't be. We'll see. It's all cleaned out pretty good. New one only goes on one way. Try to keep it pressed on to the casting until you get the screws snug, because that gasket barely sits in those channels. Looks like someone had it off but didn't change the gasket. Yeah. New gasket. Uh-oh. Couple of hoses. Pop this thing back together. We'll find out pretty quick what happened. And that's all we really want to do. Find out what happened. All right, gasket. Don't you get messed up. That's got to go on a little further. We'll get it. Throttle cable bracket, throttles back in. Clamp, two electrical connectors on the back. Got my coolant hoses all the way on. A couple of air snorkel pieces. We'll be able to fire this thing up. See how it idles. Where's it? There it is. Wires back where they go, all our cables back where they go, stands, clamps are all tight. If you haven't seen my other videos on this truck, super clean 2001 Tacoma. They look pretty similar back in the older trucks. All they did was like round off the fenders a little more and that kind of thing, but 194,000 miles is super clean, new paint, had a high idle. It's got some front end work we're going to do too, but I want to see how it idles. It ought to idle high and then come down. I do got one more vacuum hose. Gotta hook them all up, Jimmy. Knew there was something else. That's already idling better. Still cold too. It was idling at 1850 RPM and wouldn't come down. So this is why sometimes you shotgun them. Once I saw someone had already messed with it and tried cleaning it, I knew we were on the right track. The only other possibility would be if a wire was broken between the ECM and the IAC and it couldn't pull it down. But normally what happens when you shut the key off, as you shut it off, the computer opens the IAC for the next starting event. It'll already be set for high idle and then it brings it back down. When they stick, it's at high idle, it can't come back down because it can't close it. It uses voltage to pull it open and a spring to let it go back. So when they stick high, it's usually the IAC. If it was low and wasn't opening, then it's more likely to be an electrical wire problem, something like that. But I do have to get this in and do the front end work, which is one tie rod end and tightening the outer tie rod end. They left loose in this one knuckle when they raised it up. But nice Monte Carlo. The wheels don't really fit the car, but hey, you do what you like. You don't go based only on what Jimmy thinks. All right, guys, we are closing it down for today. I was hoping to get something else, but so Thanks for watching today's video, guys. I hope you got something from it. So torque the like button before you head out. Don't forget to check out my Amazon store and subscribe if you're new. Hope I see you in the next one. Because you're awesome.